I'm Matt Cornell from Cornell Engineers. Today I want to show you how I use a water level to take levels in a house.
So this is the equipment I use. I use a zip level from Technidia and a custom made stainless steel staff. The staff consists of two pieces which screw apart for easy transport. The base of the staff has a screw or a nail which is used to penetrate through carpet. The water level consists of a base unit
and a measuring head and about 30 meters of cable with hydraulic fluid inside it.
This is what the unit looks like when it's assembled and ready to go. When taking levels with this kind of water level, it's important to have enough cable out so that the base unit remains undisturbed from start to finish. When I set up the measuring head, I set it up a level lower than what it's going to be when it's on top of the staff and zero it so that all the numbers in my measuring will be positive. When taking levels on carpet, it's important to push the nail through the carpet onto the base so that the effect of the compressible carpet is taken out. I normally take levels in corners of rooms and beside windows in locations that are easy to reproduce.
So here's what a set of levels looks like after they've all been put onto a plan and scanned into the computer. And you can see that where furniture is in the way, I've used levels beside windows, and where I can, I've taken levels in the corners of the room. But by themselves, these levels don't mean anything. We need to reduce them down to a zero datum and turn them into millimeters so that we can make more sense of them. The other thing we have to take into account is changes in floor level between, for example, inside and outside on the veranda. So what we do is take two levels on either side of a doorway, for example, and then use that difference in level to adjust the numbers on the veranda so that we can produce contours right throughout the whole house. Now we're ready to reduce the levels and turn them into a contour plan so that we can analyse what parts of the house have moved and what parts we can assess as having not moved. So here we have the same floor plan being produced in our AutoCAD program, and we've located the markers that we used on site on the plan. On this page you can see that we've converted the levels to millimetres, found the lowest point and allocated it as our zero datum. So in this case we found that the lowest point in the building was in the family room and the veranda. The highest point that we found was in bedroom 3 in the corner. And then finally we interpolate between the levels to calculate lines of even level, which we plot as contours. In this case we've plotted 10 millimeter contours on the plan.
So that's how we record floor levels and turn them into contour plans at Cornell Engineers. The next step is to interpret those contour plans, but that's a whole different video. Thanks for watching.